today's video, I will show you how to make this pumpkin coaster. You could do this in orange or white. As you can see, for this coaster, use the glowing from I love this cotton brand. Now to get started, you need your hook. Today I'm using a 4.25 millimeter hook. Let's see if I could show you here. G hook, and to begin, we need our yarn, and you make a magic ring. Too big of a hole, so we'll just close that a bit. We need to make 10 double crochet into the ring. To close your circle, and we will slip stitch to the first double crochet. Alright, and that completes your round one. For round two, chain two, and we will put one double crochet back into that same stitch. Into that same one, and we'll just put two double crochet in each stitch. Oops. For this round, this one. Grab a bunch. that stitch. Two more into that last stitch. Here we go. As you can see, oops, go ahead and tighten that. This is our joining chain from round one. We will leave this unworked and we'll just slip stitch to the first. So this is our chains, 1, 2, and we'll slip stitch right there. Alright, to begin round 3, we chain 2, and we'll do 1 double crochet into that same stitch. Double crochet into the next. Oops. All right, come on, yarn. And we'll put 1 double crochet into the next. 2 double crochet next stitch. And you just repeat that pattern all the way around. Pattern of 2 double crochet in 1 stitch and 1 in the next. And I will meet you when we close this round. Alright, I have a few more stitches to do. And we'll just continue on with the pattern of 2 double crochet in 1 stitch. One double crochet in the next. And we should end up with 2 double crochet in our last stitch. Stitch to the top of double crochet, the first double crochet. Alright, and that completes round 3. Now for round 4, we chain 2 and we'll put 2 half double crochet into that same stitch. So this. Oh, and then we slip stitch next 2 stitches. Right. And we'll put 2 half double crochet into the next. One double crochet the next 2 stitches. And that's 2. And we'll put 2 double crochet next stitch. And 1 double crochet the next 2. Repeat the 2 double crochet in 1 stitch and 1 double crochet next 2 more times, so you'll have a total of 3. shark hair. So this is our first two double crochet into that same stitch. One, so that's our first set, second set, and this is our third. And we'll put half double crochet, two half double crochet into that same stitch. Oops. And we'll slip stitch the next two stitches. And we'll put two half double crochet next stitch. So one and two. One double crochet next two. Two half double crochet in that stitch and one double crochet and next two stitches, and we'll just repeat that two more times. On our last two stitches, that's one, and this is two. Go ahead and sniff your yarn, and so we can close. And we'll weave in our ends. Before I pull the needle out, I would like to check if my needle is showing here or not. And if it's not, I'll go ahead and pull my needle through. Alright, give it a little tug here. And we go back and skip a loop so that way our tail end, when we pull it, it won't go back, so it will catch that loop there, so it'll stay in place. And we'll just fully secure that tail end there, and we can go ahead and snip it off. That should complete that coaster there. We just need to add the stem and your little dangling leaf. So for the stem, I used the love this yarn brand, Brown. Get your stem in place. We will insert our hook. Let's see if we can see it. This is the 2 half double crochet we did, the very first set. So we will insert our hook after those 2 half double crochets, so it's gonna be into one of the first slip stitch we did. So insert your hook, grab your brown yarn, oops, and slip stitch there, tighten that, and we chain 5. Chain and then single crochet into the second chain from the hook, and single crochet next stitch, and we just single crochet down. 3, and the last one should be 4. Completed that 4th one. Don't complete your 4th one. Let me go ahead and just stop right there where you have 2 loops on your hook, and we will grab our green yarn. Go ahead and tighten that, and we'll go ahead and attach the green yarn there, and you should have something like this. So we will slip stitch into that second slip stitch from the previous round we did, and so it's right there. Slip stitch there, and go ahead and tighten your stitches here. Alright. Grab your working yarn, and we will chain. We'll chain 13. So 3, 4, 5, and that's 13. First loop or first chain, then we'll do single crochet, second chain from the hook, and put one more single crochet into that same one. So, and from there we will put 2 single crochet in each of the chains. Right? bring my camera down so you can see what I'm doing. But if you loop, it's stretching. That's okay. Alright, we're just gonna do two single crochet in each of the chains. Almost done. Go ahead and we will slip stitch to the next stitch. We'll attach it to this stitch right here. So I slip stitch there, and we can go ahead and sniff our green yarn. So we can move in all in. Alright. Now for the pump part. We need our darning needle. And I just want to make sure you guys can see it too here. We're not doing that yet. We're doing the brown first. Our needle through here, through that loop, and let's see if I could find it. Oh my goodness. Okay. And we just wanna weave it in to this stitches over here, or single crochet we did. So it would help if you don't do your single crochet tightly, so we could put our needle through. We go back the other way again. Oops. Okay. And we want to check there. Looks good. Go ahead and pull that through. Bit. So this one is just the yarn that we weaved in, so we want to weave in one more. So yeah, one more brown yarn. And we'll weave it in at the same spot. So this coming up a little bit at the top. So what I want to do is bring it down to the orange. I'll grab a, we'll bring it down to the orange. I will grab this loop right here. Wicked, weave it in to that same spot. Alright. And we go back. Whoops. Come on. Here we go. Now we can tuck it a little bit there. And we cut both of these ends. Go ahead and cut these. And now that brown is done. And for the green yarn, go ahead and pull that tight there. We'll weave it in. Through our green. So for this one, we want to pull it to the front. So, what I want to do is that loop, one loop right there. I want to squeeze it through this single crochets we did. Okay, but see that it's coming off at the back. I want to bring it to the front here and then grab the front loops, so that way when we cut it, on the front. So oops. There we go. And your last tail. See how this is already on the front. What I want to do is hide it to these stitches on the front. So here we are. There we go. And we can go ahead and sniff both of our green tails. And the reason why I brought the green yarn to the front, you can see, you can barely see me where I snip it off. This green yarn, this green leaves, or it will curl up, so you'll see the back side of the stitches. So that's why our tail ends are on the front. So that is the reason why it's there. So it's, you know, for a finished look. Right. That should complete your coaster.